Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have seen that quadratic equations can be solved if we can factor the quadratic expression into a pair of linear expressions. However, there are many quadratics that are not practical or even possible to factor using any of the methods we have presented so far. Over 1,000 years ago, problems like this prompted mathematicians to search for a technique that could be used to solve any quadratic equation. The breakthrough in devising a general method for solving quadratic equations was the development of a technique called completing the square by the Persian astronomer and mathematician Al-Khwarizmi. The basic idea behind completing the square is to transform a quadratic equation containing a quadratic expression that is difficult to factor into an equation with identical solutions but containing a quadratic expression that is a perfect square. Since this transformation also changes the right side of the equation, the perfect square quadratic expression ends up being equated to a non-zero constant instead of zero, so the zero product property cannot be used. However, since the quadratic expression is a perfect square, it can now be rewritten as a square of a linear expression. The square root of both sides of the equation can then be taken to simplify the equation into a form that can be easily solved. Since the square root of the square of an expression is the same as the absolute value of that expression, the square root and square can be replaced with the absolute value operation. And since the absolute value of x plus 3 is equal to the square root of 2, the value of x plus 3 can be equal to either the positive or negative square root of 2. To solve for x, we then move 3 to the right side by subtracting 3 from both sides, giving us the values of x that are the solutions to the quadratic equation. To understand the concept of completing the square, let's start by comparing two quadratic functions, x squared plus 6x plus 7 and x squared plus 6x plus 9. These two functions are identical except for their constant terms, 7 and 9. Since 9 is 2 greater than 7, the right graph is identical but shifted 2 units higher. However, there is another important difference. The function on the right is a perfect square. Since this quadratic expression is a perfect square, it has two identical linear factors. In this example, the two factors are both x plus 3. So this perfect square quadratic can also be written as x plus 3 quantity squared. In fact, all perfect square quadratics can be written as the square of a single linear expression, which is why they are called perfect squares. Since identical linear factors share the same zero, perfect square quadratic functions have only a single x-intercept, and so the vertexes of their parabolic graphs must lie on the x-axis. On the other hand, the graph on the left has two x-intercepts, so that quadratic function is not a perfect square. If we set this function equal to zero, the solutions to this quadratic equation will be the function's x-intercepts. But how can we determine these values of x? This quadratic expression cannot be factored using any of the techniques we have learned so far, so we can't find the solutions by factoring and then using the zero product property. However, by completing the square, the solutions to this equation can be found. If we add 2 to each side of this equation, the quadratic's constant term is increased by 2, shifting the parabola up by 2 units. This quadratic function is now the same as the function on the right. But since the right side of the quadratic equation has also been increased by 2, The solutions to the equation are no longer the values of x where the function is equal to 0. They are now the values of x where the function is equal to 2. These are the same x values where the original function was equal to 0. Therefore, the solutions to this equation will be the same x values as the solutions to the original equation. But unlike the original equation, we now have a way to solve this equation. Since this quadratic expression is a perfect square, it can be written as the square of a single linear expression. And as we saw, in this case, the squared linear expression is x plus 3. This equation can now be solved by taking the square root of both sides. And as we saw, since one side of the equation is the square root of a squared expression, the square root of the square can be eliminated, as long as a plus or minus sign is added to the opposite side of the equation. We can then solve for x by subtracting 3 from both sides. This gives us the two x values that are the solutions to the quadratic equation. So we have shown that by changing the value of a quadratic expression's constant term, we can change any quadratic expression into a perfect square. But how can we determine what the value of this constant term should be? In the example we just saw, we knew that a constant term of 9 would produce a perfect square, but normally we don't know this value, and so this constant must be calculated. Fortunately, this is an easy calculation, and we can illustrate graphically how this value is determined. Given any general form quadratic equation, the first step is to eliminate the x squared coefficient. This can always be accomplished by dividing both sides of the equation by that coefficient. For example, to eliminate the x squared coefficient in the equation 4x squared plus 3x plus 8 equals 0, we divide both sides of the equation by 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1. 8 divided by 4 is 2. And 0 divided by 4 is 0. The x squared coefficient of 1 can now be eliminated. And since both sides of the equation were divided by the same number, the solutions to the equation have not been affected. Therefore, in this lecture, we will always start with a quadratic equation that has been put into a form where the x squared coefficient is 1. So how do we determine the value of a constant term that will produce a perfect square? We will show that if the constant term of a quadratic expression in this form has a value of b over 2 quantity squared, that quadratic expression will be a perfect square. We can show why this is true by representing the quadratic by a group of squares and rectangles. We will represent the x squared term by a square with sides of length x. The area of that square is therefore x squared. Likewise, we will represent the term bx by a rectangle with sides of length b and x, and thus an area of bx. Or alternatively, two smaller rectangles, each with half that area. Then, all we need to complete the square is a small square with sides of length b over 2, and thus an area of b over 2 squared. So if we make the value of a quadratic's constant term b over 2 squared, then that quadratic will be a perfect square. Since the sides of this square have a length of x plus b over 2, the area of the square can be written as either x plus b over 2 quantity squared, or the quadratic expression x squared plus bx plus b over 2 squared. So if a quadratic with an x squared coefficient of 1 has a constant term equal to b over 2 squared, then that quadratic expression will be a perfect square and can also be written as x plus b over 2 quantity squared. Using this fact, we can solve any quadratic equation in the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0 by changing the quadratic's constant term to have a value of b over 2 squared. This can always be accomplished by subtracting c from both sides and then adding b over 2 squared to both sides. This gives us a perfect square expression equal to a constant. We can then write the perfect square quadratic as x plus b over 2 quantity squared. The values of x can then be found by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. So let's try an example using this technique to solve the quadratic equation x squared plus 2x minus 2 equals 0. These solutions can be found by completing the square. In this quadratic expression, the x coefficient b is 2, and the constant term c is negative 2. The first step is to move the constant term c to the right side by subtracting it from both sides, and then add b over 2 squared to both sides. Since in this example, b is 2, b over 2 squared is 2 over 2 squared. Or 1. The quadratic expression on the left is now a perfect square that, as we saw, can be written as x plus b over 2 quantity squared. And since in this example, b is 2, this perfect square quadratic can be written as x plus 1 quantity squared. Once again, we solve for x by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. So the solution set of the quadratic equation x squared plus 2x minus 2 equals 0 is negative 1 plus or minus the square root of 3. Likewise, the zeros of the function x squared plus 2x minus 2 are negative 1 plus the square root of 3 and negative 1 minus the square root of 3. In the lecture, Factoring Quadratics by Inspection Part 1, we said that the quadratic function x squared plus 9x plus 12 was not able to be factored by inspection. But as we saw in that lecture, the graph of this function crosses the x-axis at the two points x equals negative 9 plus or minus the square root of 33 over 2. So let's confirm this by setting this function equal to 0 and solving that quadratic equation by completing the square. In this quadratic expression, the x coefficient b is 9 and the constant term c is 12. Just as before, we move the constant term c to the right side by subtracting it from both sides and then add b over 2 squared to both sides. The quadratic expression on the left is now a perfect square that can be written as x plus b over 2 quantity squared. And since in this example b is 9, this perfect square quadratic can be written as x plus 9 halves quantity squared. We can then simplify the right side of the equation by squaring the fraction 9 halves, squaring its numerator and denominator. 81/4 and 12 can then be combined by first writing 12 as 48/4 and then subtracting 48/4 from 81/4, giving us 33/4. We then solve for x by taking the square roots of both sides of the equation. We can simplify further by writing 33/4 as 1/4 times 33. And since 1/4 is 1/2 squared, it can be brought out from under the radical sign. Finally, -9/2 plus or minus the square root of 33/2 can be combined into a single fraction. -9 plus or minus the square root of 33/2. So although the quadratic function x squared plus 9x plus 12 was not able to be factored by inspection, the zeros of that function can be calculated by completing the square. We have shown geometrically that any quadratic expression of the form x squared plus bx plus b over 2 squared is a perfect square. In the next lecture, we will show what happens to this geometric proof when the bx term is negative.